to another edition of a fun series. My name is Sonny Jerry, and I am playing Arcania on the PS4 once again for the 13th time. This is like the 13th episode. So as you can see right now, I had to go and talk to Duranis. And I also had to still find the water chalice, which I don't even have a clue. And I know why. Oh, that is the problem right there, huh? So, right now, yeah, I have to talk to this guy, Duranis. So, I'm going to highlight it, and I'm going to get the hell out as soon as possible. So, I think it's in outside the freaking castle. And the weird part about this, this guy is getting heavier and heavier. Yes, it is getting heavier and heavier, and right now I really don't like his walk at all. He feels like very encumbered. So right now I don't know if it's on the ground or I have to go. Yeah, I think if it's not here, I think I have to find it on the ground. Yeah. I think I have to find it on the ground. And I think I have to kill some mobs. I'll kill you and be happy with. So, anyway, I have been dealing with World of Warcraft. I played it for like a good half an hour. And I wish Warcraft would go back to the beginning, to their roots. I used to play Warcraft like crazy. Like, every time that I go to my job, every time that I get out of my job and then go home, all I think about was leveling my character to level 60. And that was before that. That was before now. It's like you have to level your character up to level 100.
Hello, my friend. Is everything all right?
Diego and Milton are fine. I urgently need to know what's going on in the Enos Temple.
A while ago, a magical battle took place there. Now the temple is cut off from the outside world by a barrier.
Where are Ningol and Medarion?
Medarion learnt about some forgotten entrance to the catacombs lying underneath the temple. He was going to secure it against the undead. Ningol passed by a short while ago. Shall I open for you?
Yes, do.
Please do, because right now I have to go there and I have to World of Warcraft. And not only because of the story, but because you can do so much things like fishing and gathering, herbalism, mining, leatherworking. It was pretty fun playing. But when one of the things that I stopped playing World of Warcraft, besides that, it's basically the changes they put on to just satisfy the new crews or the new group to make it more easy for the new. I remember when I played World of Warcraft in a dungeon and in a group, it was awesome. Especially I used to have a guild. I mean, I was a member of a guild. And it was Spanish-speaking people. And I honestly left because there were, I don't know, I don't remember that well, but it was like a back and forth. Oh, there he is. Let me go and see him talk.
Ah, our youngest member. I almost didn't recognize you.
Alas, we have no time.
Well, at least this guy has hair.
I need to get into the temple urgently.
I would not advise you to go there. Apparently, someone has raided the temple. They went in here through the catacombs and blocked all the entrances.
I know. Milton said the three of you could break the barrier in there. How about this one?
Amateur job, but supplied with a lot of power. If Ningal and I focused, we might be able to make an opening in it.
Good, you do that.
What's going on here, anyway?
Milton can give you the details. I need to kill some cultists now.
Just kill, kill, kill. So one of the things that I stopped playing in World of Warcraft, as you can see, they were like changes that I didn't like to just appeal to the newcomers or the noobs. It's like doing something lazy and you earn it. Another thing was I was involved in a guild, and I love the guild. I really love it until one day somebody started insulting me for no reason. And I was like, I'm sorry, but no. I just left. And I didn't join a guild ever since. And that is the downfall of my excitement to keep playing WoW. And the last and not least, Demons of Pandaria. I bought Demons of Pandaria, the download only, not the CD. And I thought it came up with, a 30-day subscription for free. No, it is only on the World of Warcraft that you had that. And I was like, you have to be kidding me. On top that I paid almost like, it was $40 for the download. I had to pay an additional $14.95 for the subscription, and I was like, no. And when I started playing Miss Pandaria, I was like, what the hell? I lost interest, and I haven't played ever since for approximately two years and a half. Until today. Oh, a few days. I didn't have the subscription, but I played it. I was like, okay, let me see if I could have the motivation to keep on playing, even with the Lords of Draenor. So I'm trying my best to not bash in World of Warcraft. But even though when they start doing that, shutting down a server just because, oh, they are diverting people to a free server, a subscription free server, well, that is bad. That is really, really bad for Blazer, right? I don't know. As I told you guys before, ever since Blizzard got sold out by Activision, when I see Activision, it is a bad, bad, bad name in video games. So let's go back to the battle. Wow, I had something stuck in my throat. And let's heal together. Oh no, you don't. You're not going to. What the hell are you doing? You are hiding from me. Okay. Okay, I see how you are. I see how you are. You are hiding from me. Oh, now you came out of your shell, huh? You know what I saw on my... I mean, let me tell you something. I watch TV online. I watch the most TV show, the most awesome TV show in the 90s. It's a syndicated TV show. And it's Mutant X. Finally, the good part, I could finally see Batman for 1966.
The barrier collapsed.
Only around the temple.
So I'm gonna start binging on watching it.
That seems to be a problem indeed. The Grand Masters are split over it, but it seems as if each of them came up with a possible solution. You'd better speak with them yourself.
I mean, I love Batman from the 1960s. And I always tell you guys this. Adam West and Michael Keaton are the best Batman. Did I say it right? Michael Keaton and Adam West are the best that does Batman. And I really don't like Ben Affleck for doing that. Christian Bale, on the other hand, I have a freaking dilemma right now. I got a freaking fucking dilemma right now. And it's like, I see Christian Bale in a movie from Steven Spielberg in the 1980s as a child. He is okay. I mean, he is great doing that role. I don't even know what movie is. I know it was from, I think it was Empire of the Sun, I believe. If I say it wrong, just let me know in the comments on the YouTube. But he was awesome. But after that, I'm like, oh my fuck. Let's go and talk to these guys before I just say some stuff that I may regret earlier or later.
How are we going to get a hold of the sleeper amulet?
The high mages of the temple did a good job. To remove this barrier, we'll need an enormous amount of mana. We'll practically need to entour the barrier under magical ore. But until enough ore from Corinus arrives, weeks or even months might pass.
Damn it!
I have another solution, though. In the catacombs, I discovered a hidden mana room. Following my intuition, I detached it from its setting, and now the barrier is weaker than before.
So we need to remove the other runes to cause the barrier to collapse?
That's right. Each removed rune releases the next one. We could break up the barrier piece by piece.
Where are the other runes?
Presumably hidden far out in the city. However, I was able to gain an insight into the residual of the last century input of the mages who designed the runes. If we create a mental connection, I'd be able to lead you from one rune to the next.
How many runes are we talking about?
The potency of the runes should increase exponentially, So I expect 3 more runes at the maximum.
Where's the next rune?
When I took the first rune, the following reverberation reached me. Wind in my hair. Smell of salt. I'm out of breath and feel a little dizzy. Behind me, blazing heat.
So that's what the mage sensed when he designed the second rune?
Yes, he did. Perhaps.
Oh my god, they talk too much and then they shut up. Okay. So right now, I have to talk to the next guy.
Duranis said you have an idea how to get a hold of the sleeper amulet. I'm all ears.
We could blast the barrier.
Using what?
While you were killing the false believers, a blue-skinned harpy attacked me.
And Unbale. Druhang's death must have made Zisha insecure.
Unbale? Interesting. In any case, the power of my lord was strong in her.
Sounds like Keisha.
I was stronger. Sucking her out was quite energetic.
What does that have to do with the barrier?
This barrier was created by the Sheep of Innos. If we flood it with my lord's dark power, it will break it.
Yeah, it will break it.
What do you want to do? Sacrifice on Bale on the barrier?
Their hearts should be enough. In that exquisite moment of death, the gathering of...
Thank you. I don't want to know the rest. How many hearts do you need?
I can sense another 5 on Bale. In the city, in the harbor, wealthy quarter, arena quarter, slums, and in the temple district. That should do it.
Oh my goodness. Let's go for the other guy and find out what's he's gonna
Can
do.
Can you remove the barrier?
Yes. A few days ago, I found this in the shattered remnants of a wall.
What's this?
Meteoric ore. In such a small lump, there's as much mana stored as in a head-high heap of magical ore. I carried out some research. Apparently, a star burst when the strong earthquake took place. The star's splinters rained down over the city. A few more lumps, and...
How many of those lumps do you need?
All we can get. According to my calculations, there should be at least 7 more in the city.
Do you happen to know where to find these lumps?
I do. According to eyewitnesses, 1 lump fell into the fortress. Another one hit the slums, where you activated the obelisks for Ningal. 2 others lie somewhere in the harbor quarter. And not far from here, in the temple district, 3 lumps were supposed to have landed.
Okay, so I think I have to choose one of the missions. Oh, I have to do all the missions. One or the other. You know, I just wanna play Sacred too, and I just want to broadcast it on Twitch. And right now, I have a gaming computer, but the issue is that I have to get a video game capture. Sorry, video game capture. I have to get a video capture, sorry. And it is very, not very expensive. If I wanted the high end, that would be very expensive. But I just need something that is very practical. That I could play classic games. And another thing is, I'm going to try PlayStation Now. I don't know what's the reviews for PlayStation Now and what's the speed. He disappeared. He just went from point A to point B. So, if I can do that, that would be awesome. That means that, well, I don't have to buy a video game catcher, but instead it's like, yeah. What is this? Ooh, I have rune shards. Awesome. Go ahead and see. Another game that I just wanna play is the Fallout series, like Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas. I got lucky and I got Fallout 3, the Game of the Year edition, and Fallout New Vegas, also the Game of the Year edition. I mean, one of the things that I enjoy about the Bethesda is every time that they have a new game, you wait like a year or so and they popped out with the Game of the Year editions of the game. I don't know if they're gonna do it on Fallout 4, I hope. But holy shoot me, I got a rock in there. And it's zombies everywhere. They're going to kill me. Oh, you're serious. Stop. Oh my God. Oh, you are. Oh no, you don't. What the hell, you people? Okay, I have a lot of broken brains. And there's this new TV show, I think it's on CW, the name of the TV show is Containment. I recommend you guys to watch it. I saw the first episode and it tells the story from the beginning of the outbreak in Atlanta. And basically it has good scary elements. And I just hope they don't fuck it up. That's all my wish. I got this. Let me go and get that. And I'm good to go. Come on. Come on. You know, I really, really need playing online on Arcania. Oh my goodness, they're hitting me. Like, yeah, I'm thinking low. I'm gonna get low if I don't kill these bastards. There we go. I am done. I am done. And then there's more. And let me tell you something, people. I'm not trying to be the best of the best gamer with honors. I'm just an average gamer. I have been playing video games since I was 9. And if you know my, and if I tell my age, you won't believe me. People have been saying, oh, you don't look that. You're kidding me. No, you're joking me. You're lying. Why the hell are you lying? I'm like, no, this is my real age. What are you supposed to look like? Like with wrinkles and gray hair up the yin yang and looking bad? Oh, wait a minute. I had to get my inventory. I had to get consumables right now. I don't know if I have any health. I have the elixir, but I only have one. Yeah, I can. Let me see. There you go. Thank you. I can't use that when I come back with the suck bowl. But yeah, I have been playing video games since I was 9. And my favorite types of video game there's two types. There's the PC and the console. Now there's PC, console, mobile. So I prefer console first, PC second, and mobile the third. So I have been with PlayStation ever since PlayStation 1. And now with the 2, now with the 3, and now with the 4. And I'm not going to get the 4.5. Because it's kind of like, oh, ripping me off. I mean, what's the issue of getting 4K if it's the same system, right? But a little bit more expensive. And they're going to try to lower the price of the PS4, which is bull. It is bull. No, I can't go right there because I'm going to go to the castle. So I have to go somewhere. Temple Pat. I don't know. But I'm not going to get a PlayStation 4.5 if I have a PlayStation 4. Okay, what happened with this guy? This guy just went in blue. He just went in blue like freaking Superman right now. Speaking of that, Christopher Reeve is the best Superman ever. Second one of the Superman is Dean Cain. Figure it out. I don't know where I think I have to go to this side. I hope I'm not blocked or anything. Yeah. I had to go to this path. Yeah. So right now there goes the tail of looking for the right direction. And finally, you know, I love incense. Finally, I bought lemongrass. And it is the most relaxing smell ever. I think I have to post a video about my about incense and what type of brands of incense are the best. Because basically, there are incense that they are bad, and there are incense that, you know, it's they are the best of the best. So right now, I'm gonna go back to the castle. But it's like going all around, going in the map, going all around, and going all around. So, oh my goodness. I don't know where I'm going. Let me see. I think I have to go back to the castle. It's like going in circles right now. I hate it. I don't know what the use of this thing. Okay, instead of going all the way to the place, I'm gonna go to the castle and start all over again. And trust me, I played this part offline, and damn, it was bad. It was freaking bad. I had to sell some of this stuff. I am so full of this thing. I am so full. I need to buy. I need to buy some stuff. Ooh, I just want to trade. Okay, so I got... I already had one. I got 99. I got 286. I got 42. Forty-five. 34. I'm reading the melee power. The higher melee power, I would buy it, but. Okay, so now I'm gonna go for consumables. Ooh. Yeah, but it's like 60 seconds, 30 seconds for hair regeneration. It's practically nothing. My goodness, they're fucking expensive unless I... I don't need fried chicken. And I don't need red bell peppers. Oh, she don't have nothing interesting. Why you need a torch when there's light in this castle? Look at that. They're using freaking torch to walk around when there's lights in the castle. Lights on the wall. I don't even get the sense of it. Is it that dark so they could use the torch? It's crazy. Maybe they are blind and they just want to look at it using their torches. Oh well. Gotta go, gotta go, gotta go. Okay, let's go. Let's go back in there. I have to think. I have to make some decisions. I'd rather put this. Oh, I found. Yeah, I found one. Sounds like a car. Keep on hitting me. Okay. Let me see. Now I have to go to the beginning of the place. And see how it goes. And I'm gonna go. I mean, this quest is long and tedious, in my opinion. And he feels heavy too. It's like, oh, I gained weight. I know what to do. So right now, I have to go all around this. Yes, I have to go all around, I believe. Otherwise, I have to get the long route. Your money too. Look at this. Oh, that is a multitasking. Okay, that's another fluffy bird. Just fine. Okay. So, let me go and push the skill sets. One more and I get the fireball. Okay, let's go back again to the quest. Oh, I can't even. I can't even identify where it's going. Yeah, I have to go to this. I have to go to Harbor. Yeah, I'm gonna go back to the damn castle. And I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna use this save markers going back to the Diego's place, or former Diego's place. Oh, no. I have to go inside him. What is this place? I hope they have some chests in it. Yeah. Well, you give me some good stuff. This is not bad. And some knives, which is not bad either. If only I could think, right? To go to that teleporter. I don't know if the teleporters were like, you go to the map, you go to the teleporter, and you go to point A to point B without that problem, that would be, you know, fine anyway. To go to the high board. It's going to work. Like, I really don't want to do exercise. It's very tedious. There it is. It's not blocked. There it is. In the boat. Oh, there's a violation and there's a zombie. I got help. Oh, what is this? Oh, it's mana potion. And more rotten rings. I had to sell them. Another one. Cool. This place is... I think I just scavenged this area already. Oh, not really. Ooh. More stuff. Give me more stuff. I think it's done in this area. So I have to go. Let me go to the map really quick. Yeah, I have to go to the east near the arena. So I have to place the marker right there. And go with the flow. I'm gonna go with the flow and go with the wind to see what I'm where I'm heading. Sounds poetic, right? Yeah, I think so. So I have to go back to the castle. And start from there. Oh my goodness. This is going to be the long, long thing. Let's go to crafting. No, I had to make steel ingots. But still, there's no... Let me see. Yeah, I only can make mana potions. That one is like 40 health, which is not enough. It's like, I don't have the right thing. Let's go downstairs. Like going back and forth, going around and around, and there you have it. Now I have to go for the last thing ever. Go to the arena. Yeah, I think I can eat. I hope I wouldn't never get trapped, but can open the door in there. I have been silent for a whole minute, but walking, it is relaxing and therapeutic in some of the cases. Open it up. Okay, let's go into the inventory once again and go for scrolls and recipes. Have to sell that. And I have to get rid of all those recipes. Not recipes, but scrolls that I have. There it goes. I'm getting closer. Getting closer to the Coliseum or arena. I don't know when my Spanish is conflicting with my with the English that I've been taught. I get friggin' confused. Like for example, arena in Spanish is arena, and it's, you have to say the, you know, the Spanish I, a, like an I, and it's confusing to me. There you go, the last mob, and I'm good to go. This is tedious, my friends. At least I made it in one friggin' piece. Now I have to go back to the place in one friggin' piece. I don't know, I wish I could be, I could be able to use a horse, cause man, I have been walking I'm in my level 20s. And it feels like, my goodness, I want a horse. I don't want to walk like this from point A to point B. Oh, wait a minute. I have to go this side. Yeah. It's ridiculous. I don't like this one bit. I mean, I like the game and the concept and everything, and it's the old game. But without a horse, oh my goodness. I should be size 5 by now if I do quests like this. Even my fingers are slipping from my controller.
The hearts. Give them to me.
Here are the hearts.
At last, I've prepared everything. The barrier will fall in a heartbeat.
Okay. So right now, put the... I'm gonna spare the heart. And the guy's up.
So it was actually the amulet. Good.
You bet it is. Let's get it to the king.
No.
If you tell me now you're in league with Zisha, I'll get really angry.
In its present condition, the amulet won't help the king. It needs to be taken back to the monastery on the cliff.
Oh,
it's a long journey.
No.
I hope the undead didn't sink Diego's boat.
Bring me the amulet. I've got the setting. You'll need it.
The setting?
When you are in the monastery, you'll understand. The northern lighthouse of Thorniara stands directly over a ley line. I've created a powerful teleportation spell that'll take you directly to my tower. The monastery is not far from there.
You mean the lighthouse with the eerie glow?
Yes. Your path leads through the graveyard. I've ordered Gorn to open the gate and clear the road for you.
That's where he is.
Hmm. So now I have to go to the lighthouse. Sounded like row house. But then again, it's not row house, it's a lighthouse. So... I have to eliminate this. Then go to the quest. Now I have to look for Gorn at the cemetery. So it is up there. So I have to go. Wow, there is a gang. I didn't see these people now. I'm trying. Gonna get those weapons and arm and shields out of your hand. Good as dead, and somebody has been hitting me. Where are you? Are you running from me? Yes, you are running from me. I see you. I see you on the radar. Oh, well. Oh, now you're coming back. Now you're coming back after you were, like, running away like a chicken. Who don't want to be a pot pie. But you are a pot pie. You definitely are a cooked pot pie. All right, he's walking. Ooh. Yeah, I'm getting closer. Getting closer to it. Oh my goodness, I wish I could have a horse. It is more easy to get a horse than walking or running.
Getting older each day.
What happened?
Nothing. I'm just exhausted. I used to fight day and night. Now these bones aren't young enough anymore.
Oh, kind of like
you deal with the rest, kiddo. But you aren't so small anymore. I see you gained some muscles.
All right, Gorn. I'll give those skeletons a smack in the gob from you.
Off with you, to the lighthouse.
Okay, let's see what I have. Is it exceptional? 45? Oh, no. I ain't passing at that powerful. And then I have to sell some of the stuff. Let me see if I find something interesting, but no, I'm gonna sell some of this stuff. No, that is for magic and just yeah, that's magic too. Wow, Ring of the Woods, and I got the Olum Ring. Holy cow, I got a lot of shit in there. I think I'm gonna go for the missing. You are there to kill me, I will let you shoot you back. Oh no, you don't. Go to that shield. All I want to go and all I want to do is just get into the lighthouse. Not the roadhouse, but the lighthouse. Awesome, I found a black diamond, but I don't know what the use is for. There's one of my dogs barking right now. Oh, there's a chest over there. Okay, I did a bat move. There you go. And oh, this is good. I have to find out. And just one moment. Phoebe! Phoebe, come over here! Phoebe! Phoebe! No, Dulcer! Come on, Phoebe! Come on, Phoebe! 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 Dulcer, well, you have to be such a douchebag sometimes, hmm? Oh my goodness, Dulcer. Now it's like petting time for like 5 seconds or 5 minutes. That's depending. Come on, Dulcer. Phoebe. 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 Come on. Come on, Dulcer. Dulcer, stop being a douche. You are Mr. Douchey. You know you are. Okay. Okay, let's go. Let's go to the end of the tunnel.